on, you got more than that. Come on.
What are they saying?
There's a crazy crowd here in Chicago.
CM Punk, I think.
Raw's been able to morph through the years. One of the reasons why it has, we reinvent Raw all the time. Here's one of the reasons why it has, we reinvent Raw all the time.
It's done that a couple times.
In order to reinvent Raw, well, there's certain eras, certain iterations and eras that have occurred. Matter of fact, one of my favorite eras of Monday Night Raw would be the Attitude Era. But now we have a new era in Monday Night Raw. We need someone who has new leadership skills.
Shame.
Someone who has a great personal set of ethics.
Shame.
Someone who has great business acumen.
Shame.
Someone, business acumen. Someone, someone who has a vision as to where we should be going. This person indeed needs to be not just a great business person, but a great person of personal ethics. So we're at a decision here. Who should be running Monday Night Raw? Should it be my son Shane?
Yes.
Or should it be my daughter Stephanie?
Okay, then I guess you got a thing.
I don't always appreciate your point of view, by the way. So please welcome, without further ado, my daughter Stephanie.
Oh, you asshole.
There she is. So is this Mr. Revenge's choice? Oh, I think it would be, of course. It'd have to be.
No. Rebel. Your daddy wasn't on Window Maker.
Well, how you know he wasn't?
Trust me, I know.
Did you just like rarely come up with that?
No.
Rebel. No.
You know, first and foremost, I would like to just thank all of you for your outpouring of support, compassion, and sympathy after Roman Reigns viciously speared me at WrestleMania. Shut up! Shut up!
That's why I'm calling it. That is funny.
You people in Chicago are animals. You're animals.
Yes, I am.
Show some respect.
It's all right, Dad. You know what? Quite frankly, I don't want their support, and I certainly don't want their compassion or their sympathy, because I would rather be feared or respected than felt sorry for. Because I am a leader, and all of you know it.
No, not.
Under the authority's leadership,
you're a bitch.
We saw the biggest WrestleMania in WWE's history.
You're recording
we saw the
Oops.
Divas Revolution become a woman's
evolution. Did I get that on camera?
We saw
yes.
The debut of superstars
bitch.
Like The Shield, Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Roman Reigns.
Which you all hate.
Kevin Owens, the tag team champions, The New Day. Becky Lynch, the boss, Sasha Banks, the women's champion, Charlotte Flair. And even tonight's number one contender, AJ Styles. But perhaps the biggest accomplishment under the authority's leadership was the launch of the WWE Network, taken from a germ of an idea into 1.8 million subscribers, a network created for all of you to give you the value that you demanded and that you so richly deserve. Now, you may not agree with all of my decisions. I may not be the most popular candidate here, decision I have ever made has always been what's best for business.
No.
Unlike my brother Shane. Now, the only reason why Shane McMahon thinks that he can run Monday Night Raw is because, well, he's a man. And his myopic and misogynistic view of this world will be the downfall of WWE. And besides that, Dad, when the going got tough, what did Shane McMahon do? What did he do? He abandoned every single one of you for 7 years. That's a leader. That's someone you want leading this company. What's going to stop Shane from doing that all over again? And besides that, Dad, Shane lost his match to The Undertaker at WrestleMania. He was so desperate to defeat The Undertaker, he leapt off the top of the Hell in the Cell. And while that move was quite spectacular, there is no denying that that risk was just clear stupidity. And Dad, I know that you don't want to hear this or be reminded of this, but Shane, the only way that he got his foot back in this